Hey everyone, so I'm gonna start a series where I break down my perfume collection and kind of go through each brand and like each perfume that I own. And I currently have 33 and 4 are coming in the mail, so those will be included in the series too. I'm gonna break it down into probably 3 or 4 parts. But today I'm gonna be focusing on my Dior perfumes, my Burberry perfumes, my Marc Jacobs perfumes, and 2 miscellaneous perfumes by brands I only have one of each. So first is Chanel Chance Eau Vive. Now, this is such a beautiful, like, citrusy and fresh fragrance. I wore all the time this past summer and early to late spring. It's just very refreshing, it's very citrusy, it's very fun, and it just smells really refreshing. So it's described as a floral woody musk. Now, I can see that, but the main accord is citrus, and that's really what stands out. It's citrus, woody, and then fresh, spicy, and then there's a whole bunch of other accords, but you really get the woodiness and the citrusy. The top notes are all citrus. It's a blood orange, grapefruit, and citrus in the top. Middle is jasmine and white musk. And the base is cedar, vetiver, and iris. So all in all, it's like very beautiful, very fresh, but still with a little musk to it, a little woodiness. But very refreshing and very light and like a perfect summer wear, spring summer. Good for those hot days where you don't want to feel like too overpowered by a perfume. So I'm going to sample this because I haven't worn it since the summer, and although I know I like this a lot, I just kind of need to refresh my mind. So right off the bat, I'm getting the woodiness and the musk, but it's kind of balanced with the grapefruit and the citrus notes. Very grapefruity in my opinion. I can also smell lemon and lime. Fragnatica doesn't specify which citruses, it just says citruses, but to me, it's very lemon lime, and then of course with the grapefruit. So the woodiness kind of goes down, and it just becomes more and more fresh as it's drying on this paper, and that's pretty much how it dries on me. It just kind of becomes a very bright, citrusy scent as the day goes on, and I really love it. I used like a lot of it this summer, probably like a third of the bottle, and I would have to rate it probably a 7, and that's just because it's kind of not too complex. It's just kind of like a very nice fresh citrus scent. I feel like a lot of people could like this and wear it, and it's nothing too overpowering or too unique or like abrupt. So it's beautiful, but it's not an all-time favorite of mine. It's definitely like an everyday casual summer fragrance. But it's still lovely, and 7 out of 10. So next I'm going to be talking about my Dior perfumes. Now I only have 3, and one of them is a recent purchase of mine, and that is Miss Dior EDP, the 2021 edition. So the main accords here are vanilla, powdery, and rose, and then fruity and floral, and then a whole bunch of other stuff. And the top notes are iris, peony, lily of the valley, and then the mid notes are apricot, rose, and peach, And at the base, it's vanilla, musk, tonka bean, benzoin, and sandalwood. So I've honestly recently got this and I haven't worn it on myself yet. So I'm gonna need a refresher and like spray a little bit. Just because it's very much a spring perfume, and so I haven't had an opportunity. It's been very cold lately, and it's only January, so I'm gonna need a refresher because I don't remember really how it smells from the day I bought it. Right off the bat, I get the powdery and the vanilla. The vanilla kind of sweetens it, and it's not like overly powdery. It's honestly like very sweet and like refreshing. It smells really clean, very feminine, very soft, honestly. As it's drying down, I can smell a little bit more of the musk. And yeah, oh, that's beautiful. But yeah, definitely the musk and the vanilla really stand out to me. And then the top florals also kind of give it this feminine and springy, fresh feel to it. So I think I'm gonna rate this one an 8.5, because although it's a recent purchase and I don't know exactly how it dries down on me, just from smelling it and like reading the notes and the accords and just kind of sitting here with it for a minute, it's beautiful, and this is gonna be like very much my spring vibe, I feel like. Oh, I can't wait to wear this. 8.5 for Miss Dior ADP 2021. And next, we have Miss Dior Absolutely Blooming. This was my first Dior fragrance that I bought, and it's honestly been one of my all-time favorites, like, ever. The main accord is fruity, and then it's rose, floral, sweet, woody, musky, soft, spicy, and fresh. And I also haven't worn this in a while, because to me, it's very much a spring perfume, but I adore this fragrance, and let's go to the notes. The top notes is raspberry, blackcurrant, pomegranate, and pink pepper, and I feel like upon first spray, that's like very noticeable. It has this tart, fruity opening, and that kind of stays, at least for me, that kind of stays as it dries down. But then the muskiness and the May Rose and the peony from the middle and the base kind of dry down very beautifully. And it's definitely a strong fragrance, and like strong as in it definitely lasts on people and people will smell it. And it's definitely nothing subtle. It's very sweet. It's very feminine. It has the tartness. It has the fruitiness. And just for a refresher, I'm gonna spray it because it's been a few months. So yeah, I haven't even smelled this like little paper, but I'm already getting the pink pepper and the raspberry. Yeah, the pink pepper like kind of died down already, but the raspberry and the blackcurrant add like a beautiful tartness to it. Oh, it's so lovely. And yeah, the musk is starting to come out. Again, this is just gorgeous and like one of my all-time fave perfumes. And it's definitely a spring, feminine, girly, sweet, beautiful perfume. And I have to give it a 10. This is a 10 out of 10. I love everything about it, and even months after not wearing it for a while, I still love it, and this is just a reminder of why. So last Dior fragrance that I have is Hypnotic Poison EDT. Now, I talked about this in my last video, the vanilla perfume video. And yes, so as we know, it's a vanilla perfume. That's the main accord here. Then it's sweet and almond. And as I mentioned last time, very much get the vanilla and the almond. And those kind of last with you. And it has a little bit of woodiness and spice to it. And a little bit of sweetness because the top has coconut, plum, and apricot. And then the base has vanilla and almond and sandalwood and musk. So it kind of starts a little spicy and woody, but it still has the sweetness from the top three notes and then from the vanilla, obviously. And then as it dries down, it's very much a vanilla almond scent. And it's like very sexy and it's very delectable. And I talked about it a lot in my last video, so just gonna spray this one and give it a rating. It's a little different on the skin, but I initially smelled the coconut, but as it dried fairly quickly on this paper, I'm getting way more almond and vanilla. And that's kind of how it is on me too, but it's definitely sweeter on the skin, and I like how it smells on my skin a lot more. But I also have to give this a 10. It's honestly one of my favorite like vanilla perfumes, and it's so sexy and beautiful and sophisticated and delicious and like a perfect vanilla wintry vibe. And I love this. So 10 out of 10 for her. So this next perfume is by Kenzo, and it's the only fragrance of theirs that I have, and I've had this probably for about a year now. I've only worn it like once or twice, and that is Kenzo Jungle L'Elefant. I probably butchered the French pronunciation of the L'Elefant, but there we go. So this is described as a amber spicy on Fragnatica and a spicy oriental on Parfumo. So I'm definitely leaning towards spicy oriental. It definitely has a lot of spice to it. It's definitely your fall winter vibe. The main accord is a warm spicy. And then there's some vanilla, some sweet, and then some other spicy accords. The top note is clove, cumin, and mandarin orange. The middle note is cardamom, caraway, licorice, mango. I honestly don't know how to say this, but lang lang or ylang lang. Butchered that, I'm sure. Heliotrope and gardenia. And then the base has vanilla, amber, and patchouli. So, I honestly have to spray this because I'm honestly not too fond of it, and I've only worn it twice in the entire year of owning it. Definitely not something I'd wear like on the day-to-day, regardless of the season or the weather. Yeah, immediately I'm hit with a lot of spices, and I don't own many like spicy and oriental perfumes, so I can't like pick out the specific spices, but it's like a whole lot of spices. I kind of get some sweetness from the mango, honestly. And I can subtly smell the patchouli at the base. The licorice and all the other spices are the strongest part. And I'm honestly not too fond of licorice. It smells kind of old to me. It smells kind of like an old person, but not in like a lovely way. The only reason I really keep this around is because it's like very unique. And it's definitely a lot of spices, but it kind of just reminds me of a church almost, like all the spices and herbs that they kind of throw around and like smoke and whatever. Yeah, it's just very old. Very distinctive. And also very strong, if I remember correctly from the times I wore this. Yeah, it's definitely very heavy on the licorice. And I have to give this, like a 4, maybe 3. 3 in terms of my enjoyment, 4 because it's pretty unique. And though it's not my taste, I think they did a good job of composing the spices, although it leans very heavily licorice. And I almost get none of the vanilla in it, and hardly any of the fruits that were mentioned in the notes. But yeah, the bottle is beautiful, and like the notes and the overall composition is what really intrigued me to get this. But I would probably never wear it again, and I'm probably honestly might not be in my collection for much longer, but yeah, between a 3 and a 4. So next I'm going to be talking about my Marc Jacobs perfumes. And I only have 3, but I've smelled and sampled tons of Marc Jacobs. And every time I smell their fragrances, I usually love or like it a lot. But I only own 3. And the first one I'll be talking about is Perfect Intense. So I got this in September of 2022. And it was kind of like a good go-to everyday perfume, in my opinion, for like the late fall. And that's kind of where I wore it most. It's very much like an almondy and nutty fragrance, but in a sweet way. And it has some saltiness to it too, which I like. It's definitely very toasty and very much fall-winter. The main accord is almond, and then there's fruity, nutty, sweet, and yellow floral, white floral, woody, green, and then floral. And the top notes are narcissus and night blooming jasmine. The middle note is almond, and the base is sandalwood. So I'm going to spray this, although I wore it recently, actually yesterday, I think, but just for the sake of this video, just to remember everything as best I can. So yeah, right away, I smell the jasmine at the top, and then you get the almond too. It's like florally, but then it has like that toasty, salty, nutty edge to it. But it's still pretty sweet. And one way I describe this perfume is like, it's kind of buttery and like a salty sweet sense. And I say that like with the most love, because I love this perfume, and like buttery might sound disgusting, but that's absolutely not the case. I think it's like really unique. And just between the flowers, the woody notes, and the toasted almonds, it's just a very nice balance of soft and woody, and then salty and sweet, and it has like a nice, yeah, like buttery fragrance. I don't know how to say it otherwise, but I really like it. I think I'd have to give this a 9. It's definitely like one of my favorites and like a go-to for the fall and the winter, and it's good for every day. Yeah, it's a solid 9. Like, it's a very nice perfume. Next up is the Original Daisy by Marc Jacobs, obviously. This is kind of just your typical classic white floral. A lot of people own this, so I'm sure everyone has smelled what this is like. But Let's go dive in a little bit more. So yeah, the main accord is azonic, and then it's white floral and powdery. And then there's a bunch of other accords following it. Yeah, it's a white floral, like that's kind of the main vibe of this. The top notes are violet leaf, blood grapefruit, and strawberry. And when you spray it, I get a lot of the strawberry-ness. It kind of has like a nice sweetness to it from the strawberry. And then it's just surrounded by a bunch of like beautiful florals. And in the base, there's musk, white woods, and vanilla. Oh, and then the middle has gardenia and jasmine and violet. And yeah, let's test it out. So, right away, I get the violet leaf because it has like a very naturey and fresh smell to it, but not like florally, like kind of leafy. And then it sweetens up and softens a little bit with the strawberry, which I think is like a very unique berry like note. I feel like I see it way less in fragrances, at least in my collection. But yeah, the strawberry makes it like very sweet and very cute. And then as it dries down, you get like strong jasmine and gardenia, at least for me. And yeah, the base has musk, white woods, and vanilla. I don't really pick up on the vanilla and musk that much. The white woods, yeah, because it kind of goes with that naturey, fresh feel. And this is just like a nice perfume. Like, it's nothing special. It's pretty inoffensive. Like, yeah, it's just like a simple white floral. Perfect for spring. Perfect when you don't know what you want to wear. Perfect if you don't want anything too crazy. Yeah, I think it's just like a nice perfume to have. Like, it's not an all-time favorite. So I'd give it like a 6.5, maybe a 6. It's cute. It's pretty. And then lastly for Marc Jacobs, we have Daisy Love Oh So Sweet. This is the first Marc Jacobs I purchased. And oh my god, I love this so much. Yeah, it's a sweet and fruity, and it's perfect for spring. If you want to feel girly and youthful and kind of light and pillowy, and it almost has like a marshmallow vibe to it. Yeah, so let's get into the notes. And yeah, the top has raspberry, blackberry, and bergamot. The middle has daisy and jasmine, and the base is sugar, musk, white iris, and woodsy. So, right away when I spray it, I get like a blast of the raspberry and blackberry. It has that sweet but tart fruitiness that I love in any fragrance. It's just very vibrant and juicy and like very tart and berry like. And then as it dries down, I can smell a little bit of the jasmine. And I definitely smell the sugar, and that's kind of what gives it the sweetness that makes it almost smell like a marshmallow. It's just very like marshmallowy, pillowy, girly, sweet. It's delicious. Like, I don't know. I wish I could taste this perfume. And it's like one of my favorite spring fragrances to have. And I'd have to give this a 10. Like, I really love it. It's so perfect for spring, at least during the daytime. Definitely for a fun, youthful vibe. It's nothing mature or sexy or sophisticated, but it's just deliciously sweet, and I love it. So lastly, we're gonna talk about my two Burberrys. Now, I recently have been getting into the Burberry vibe. My first Burberry being Burberry Her Elixir, which I talked about a lot in my last video, and I raved about it, and I love it. It's just very good. Berries, it has berries in the top, vanilla in the base, and it's so warm, it's so delicious. I'm not gonna go too far into detail because it's very much talked about and loved in my last video, but for the sake of this one, I'm gonna spray it again and kind of give my rating and my thoughts. Yeah, the berries. The berries are what really make it for me and make it kind of a unique and delectable vanilla. Sometimes I think vanilla can smell a little candly, but this vanilla is like, no, it has the sweet fruitiness and a subtle tartness that I really enjoy in berry perfumes. It's so good. This is like an easy 10 for me. This is like all I wore in the winter, and I'm gonna keep stocking up because this is delicious, it's beautiful, it's warm, it's a gorgeous, sweet, very sweet vanilla. So you have to like that vibe, but I love it. Easy 10, Burberry Her Elixir. And lastly, we have Burberry Her London Dream. Now, this is a recent purchase and it's very much a spring perfume, so I'm gonna have to look up the notes because I have yet to wear it on myself, but it's very beautiful. If I can pull up the notes. Here we go. So the main accord is rose and then fresh, then floral, and then citrus. And yeah, it's definitely your spring summer Burberry Her fragrance. It's not really like the other two hers, the Elixir and the original. It's described as a floral fragrance. The top note is ginger and lemon. And that is what really sold me because I could really smell the ginger, and I feel like that's so, like, at least in my experience, pretty uncommon to, like, first of all, see a ginger note and then be able to, like, smell it as strongly as I did. It has that spicy, quality that, like, a ginger has. And then the lemon adds the citrusy freshness. And then the middle is peony and rose. I can smell the rose. That's what gives it that springy floral vibe. And then at the base, there's musk and amber. I don't really get either of those, but I mean, again, I'm only smelling this for a brief amount of time. It could dry down way differently. But I don't smell the amber per se, but it definitely gives it a warmth that a lot of fresh springy perfumes don't have, especially like citrusy ones. So I think it's like a unique combo of spicy, citrusy, fresh, sweet, and warm, but fresh. And it's refreshing. And I think the ginger and the lemon at the top are brilliant. And I can't wait to wear this in the spring. This is an 8.5 out of 10. So yeah, that's it. And thanks for watching this far. The next video will be another group of perfumes, and I hope to see you there. Thank you.